This morning around 7:45, officers were dispatched to Crescent and Outer Loop on an accident. When they arrived, the person inside the vehicle had advised they'd been shot. EMS was contacted and they were transported down to University Hospital, where they were taken to room 9 and taken immediately surgery. I don't have an update on the status of the victim at this point. Come to find out, we had another run down the road a little bit where there was a gentleman who was on the interstate who said that he had been in a fight with somebody in reference to a car, and that he was potentially a shooter. So we're waiting to get the full story on that. All parties, we believe at this point, are going to be in custody. And both of them are at University Hospital being treated for differing injuries. And I don't have a status update at this point on either one of the victims.
You think the same person here was also the same person that got in the altercation?
We were told, before this accident came out, we were alerted about a fight that was occurring on 65. We believe that both of these are going to be related, but this is the very beginning stages of the investigation, so I'm sure a lot more information will come out as we go along. But at this point, the only thing I can say for sure is that we believe right now that all parties are in custody, and we'll leave it to the major crimes units to sort out what needs to happen in regards to charges or who's at fault in this incident.
Are we talking like a fist fight on 65?
The only thing I can tell you is a fight. That was the run that we got, was a fight run. I don't know what the deal was, but it sounds like all of them are going to be connected. I just don't know what the connection is at this point. Like I said, we're less than an hour after we got the initial run, so we're still trying to sort all this out. It'll take a little bit, but we'll have it all sorted out, hopefully by the end of the day.
Was this a possible carjacking? Is that something you can confirm?
I can't confirm that because I don't know at this point, because we haven't been able to talk to both parties to find out what the circumstances were. So I don't want to sit here and say it was a carjacking when it could have just been an altercation between two people that got into a fight. So, I don't want to just push out things without having any kind of confirmation that it is what it is.
But with it being possibly two scenes, I mean, you said there was a fight on I-65. Does that make this investigation a little bit longer, because you got two scenes instead of one technically?
Well, no, it really does. It's not going to make it much longer. It's just you're going to have to separate resources in order to investigate both parts. It takes a little bit of time, but it's not. We've seen multiple homicide shootings and stuff like that where your scene is vast from all the shell casings and stuff, and that takes a long time to do the proper collection of evidence. With this, it's more about just identifying the exact area where things took place, and video and photographing and collecting evidence.
And real quick, how far was that first scene from here? Do you know?
I don't know exactly where that scene, the dispatch run came out. I'm not sure about that. It wasn't far. It was up on 65, like close to the Outer Loop exit, but I don't know which side.
Like northbound, southbound?
I want to say northbound, but I can't say with 100% certainty what
on
it was.
65,
it was on 65, but I just don't, I'm pretty sure 65 north, just north of Outer Loop, but I don't know the exact location where it happened at.
I mean, it could literally be right around the corner.
Could be, yeah. But I mean, 65's up the road just a ways, so it's very convoluted at this time, and that's why I don't like doing these things right after the incident happens, because it's unclear to everybody, and it sounds like when we talk about this stuff, we don't know what's going on. The bottom line is, this early in the investigation, you really don't. You're just trying to piece together everything you can, and as everything unfolds, that's when you start learning about how everything transpired. 45 minutes to an hour after an incident happens, the information that you have is very limited. And we tell people, because we want them to know, we've got people in custody, everybody seems to be accounted for at this time. We don't want people worrying that there's somebody out here doing crazy stuff. But the bottom line is, past that, that's pretty much the extent of what we know at this point.
Would you consider one or both of these incidents road rage incidents?
I'm not going to comment on that because I don't know the full set of circumstances. That's going to be for the investigative body to determine once they get involved with this entire incident that occurred. They'll be able to speak more on that once they get some, they interview all parties, any witnesses, collect evidence. They'll have a better idea of that. Me saying that at this point, that would be irresponsible. I wouldn't have a good idea about that.